Hello and welcome to Nikolai's Genetics Lessons, and today's problem I got from one of my subscribers, and here's a problem: albinism in an autosomal recessive condition characterized by absence of melanin pigment from the skin, eye and hair. Two carriers of albinism marry and plan to have 5 children, assume 1-to-1 sex ratio. What is the probability that at least 3 children will be normal? First of all, I want to simplify this problem. We don't need this phrase at all. So assume 1-to-1 sex ratio. This trait is not sex related and nothing is asked about sex ratio of the progeny, who has the disease and who doesn't. So this phrase are just not necessary for our problem solving. So just let's a little bit simplify the problem. According to our problem, 2 carriers of albinism marry. So both parents are heterozygous. So genotype of one parent would be capital A small a, and genotype of the other parent would be capital A and small a. Let's build simple Punnett square and let's see what is the probability for the progeny to be affected or to be of the normal phenotype. So capital A here, capital A here, capital A here, and small a here. Only those people who inherit 2 recessive alleles would be affected. And it's going to be 1/4 of the progeny. But 3/4 of the progeny are going to be phenotypically normal, though some of them would be also carriers just like their parents, but phenotypically would be normal. So we expect that 3/4 of the progeny are going to be phenotypically normal. Except simple Punnett square, we also are going to need to build Pascal's triangle in order to solve this problem. If you don't know how to build Pascal's triangle, here is a theory. So first we put 1 on top. In the second row, we put 1 and 1. In the third row, we start with 1, then we put 2, which is going to be 2 combined numbers from the top row, and 1 on the backbone of this pyramid. And again, we start with 1, then put 3, which is going to be combination of these 2 numbers, then 3 again, which is going to be combination of these 2 numbers, and 1 again. Next row, we start with 1, then we put 4, which is going to be a combination of these 2 numbers, then we put 6, which is going to be a combination of the numbers from the row above, then we are going to put 4 and 1. And the next row is going to be, again, we start with 1, then next number is going to be a combination of these 2 numbers, so 5. Then combination of these 2 numbers, so it's going to be 10. Combination of these 2 numbers, so going to be 10. Combination of these 2 numbers, so going to be 5 and 1. This row is going to be row 0, so let's put 0 here. Next row is going to be row number 1, row number 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now, if we combine all the numbers in each row, we are going to get following numbers. For the row 0, it's going to be 1. For the row number 1, it's going to be 2, 1 plus 1. For the row number 2, it's going to be 4, 1 plus 2 plus 1 is going to be 4, then 8, 16, and 32. As you see, these numbers with each following row just going to double each time. Now let me explain how this Pascal triangle is going to help us. Let me use such example, like what is the probability that in a family with one child it's going to be a girl or a boy. And probability would be 1-to-1. So 50% probability that it's going to be a boy and 50% probability that it's going to be a girl. So we also can say that each row here represent a ratio. For example, in a family with 2 children, what is the probability of having boys and girls. And ratio is going to be 1, that it's going to be 2 boys, to 2, that it's going to be a boy and girl, and 1, that is going to be 2 girls. Again, in a family of 2 children. So we can have boy and boy, 1 combination, girl and girl, 1 combination, but we can have 2 combinations of boy and girl. First child can be a boy and then a girl, and another combination can be that first child is a girl and then a boy. Hence, 1:2:1 ratio. And in a family with 3 children, we may have 1 combination of the 3 boys, 1 combination of 3 girls, 3 combinations of 2 boys and 1 girl, and 3 combinations of 2 girls and 1 boy. In relation to our problem, each row here would represent ratios of the children who would have a disease and who is going to be normal. I will return to this Pascal's triangle a little bit later and to this Punnett square. And now let me list all different combinations that are possible for this family to have 5 children. For example, 1 combination would be when all 5 children would have a disease. So I would put annotation 5D, meaning 5 children with disease. And in this case, 0 children who is going to be normal. And another variant would be when 4 children is going to have a disease and 1 would be normal. Another variant would be when 3 children is going to have a disease and 2 would be normal. Another variant when 2 children is going to have a disease and 3 would be normal. And yet another combination would be when 1 child is going to have a disease and 4 is going to be normal. And the last combination when all 5 children would be phenotypically normal. According to our Punnett square, you should remember that probability to have a child who has disease is 1/4 each time this couple conceive a child, and 3/4 probability that the child is going to be phenotypically normal. For this combination, let's find out what is the probability to have 5 children who are going to have this disease. So it's going to be 1/4 times 1/4 times 1/4 times 1/4 and times 1/4. So it's going to be 1/1024. Now let's find probability for this family to have 4 children with disease and 1 normal. And probability would be as follows. 1/4 times 1/4 times 1/4 and times 3/4. This is probability to have a child who is going to be phenotypically normal. So the answer is going to be here 3/1024. Let's move to the next step and let's find what is the probability to have 3 children with disease and 2 phenotypically normal. And probability is going to be 1/4 times 1/4 times 1/4 times 3/4 times 3/4. 3 times 3 is going to be 9, so the answer is going to be 9/1024. Next row, probability of having 2 children with disease and 3 normal would be 1/4 times 1/4 times 3/4 times 3/4 times 3/4. So the answer is going to be 27/1024. And next, let's find probability to have 1 child with disease and 4 who is going to be phenotypically normal. 1/4 times 3 quarters times 3 quarters times 3 quarters times 3 quarters. And the answer is going to be 81 over 1024. And the last combination, to have 5 children and all of them going to be normal. So 3 quarters times 3 quarters times 3 quarters times 3 quarters times 3 quarters. 243 over 1024. Now, if you combine all these fractions, you are not going to get 1024 over 1024. So what's wrong with these calculations? And we need one more step. We need to return to this Pascal's triangle. And let me explain one more time what this row means. In a family with 5 children, this 1 stands for the 1 combination. How this family may have 5 children who are going to have this disease? Only one such combination are possible. So this 1 stands for such combination of having 5 children with disease. So we have to multiply this fraction by 1 and we are going to get the same number, 1 over 1024. Now let's move to this number. What this number represent? Again, do you remember that this is a ratio? And this number represent 5 possible combinations how this family may have children with disease. 4 would have a disease and 1 would be normal. So normal can be first child, it can be second, third, fourth, and fifth. So 5 different possible variants when normal child can be first child, second child, third child. So 5 different variants are possible. So 5 combinations. So we have to multiply by 5 and we are going to get 5 over 1000. 24. Next, we have 10 here, and 10 stand for the probability to have 3 children with disease and 2 who is going to be normal. So we can get 10 different combinations. For example, first 3 children can be with disease and the last 2 can be normal. But also we can get combination when first 2 children would be normal and the rest would have disease. Also another combination when first child normal, last child normal, and the rest with disease. So as you see, if you list all the possible combinations, you're going to get this 10. So 10 different combinations. So times 10 and we are going to get 90 over 1024. And next, this 10 also stands for the number of possible combinations, how we can get 2 children with disease and 3 are going to be normal. So we have to multiply this fraction by 10 and we are going to get 270 over 1024. Next, we also can get 5 different combinations how this family may have 1 child with disease and 1 normal. With disease, it can be first child, second, third, fourth, and fifth. So 5 different combinations are possible. So times 5. And we are going to get 405 over 1024. And the last combination, how many possible combinations would be to have 5 children who is going to be all healthy? Only one such combination exists, when all 5 children are going to be normal. So times 1, and the number is going to be the same, 243 over 1024. Now let's return to our problem and let's read it again. Take a look. What is the probability that at least 3 children will be normal? Let me underline. At least 3 children. Not 3 children, but at least 3 children. It is 2 different things. At least 3 normal children means that it can be 3, 4, and 5. But for example, if family would have 2 children, who is going to be normal? It doesn't meet requirements of our problem. And if 1 would be normal, also doesn't meet requirements of our problem. And 0 also doesn't meet requirements of our problem. So it's have to be 3, 4, or 5 normal children. And let's take a look. Only these 3 variants meet requirements of our problem. And now our final step in our calculations. So we have probability of having 2 children with disease and 3 normal as 270 over 1024. So now we have just to combine this probability. So 270 plus 405 to have 1 child with disease and 4 normal. So plus 405 plus 243 to have 5 normal children, 243 over 1024. So it's going to be 918 over 1024, and the decimal answer is going to be 0.897. If you need an answer in percent form, times 100, and the answer in percent form is going to be 89.7%. And this is going to be our answer today. So for this family, probability to have at least 3 normal children, it can be 3, it can be 4, it can be 5, is going to be 89.7%. And this is all for today. Thank you for attention. Please subscribe for my new videos that I post almost every day. And see you in the next video. Goodbye.